Here's what I love about our next guest here. She's a wife, she's a mom, she's a home chef who happens to do a food blog. She gave up her corporate, huge, muckety-muck job and decided, I'm going to be a paleo chef. She educated herself about the paleo lifestyle, which we hear so much about, and she's here to shed more light on that and make something paleo Italiano, which is, by the way, the name of her new book. It's Paleo Italian Cooking. Cindy Barbieri, welcome to Daytime. Oh, so nice to meet you.
Jerry, it's so wonderful to be here.
I have seen you on other shows, Dr. Oz, and all of those big shows you do, and we appreciate you coming here. For those who don't understand or don't know what paleo is, just explain that briefly.
So, you know, in a nutshell, basically, paleo is, mimics the way the caveman ate, our ancestors. So, fresh vegetables from the garden, you know, they hunted and gathered all their meals. So nothing processed.
Right.
Nothing man-made. Everything is
fresh. How we should all be eating.
Absolutely.
And people can lose weight on it.
Absolutely. And some people think the paleo diet is expensive, but it's really not. If you go to farmers markets and plan out your meals, it's really affordable.
Okay, so what are we making today? I know it's going to be paleo, and I know it's going to be Italian.
Yes.
So that's all I need to know.
We are making spaghetti squash, chicken ragu.
Oh, I love this. So without the glutinous pasta.
No pasta. We're going to have the spaghetti squash as our pasta, so let's get cooking.
Okay.
I have my pan warming on a nice medium-high heat, and we're going to add some coconut oil.
Love it.
I love cooking with coconut oil.
Too.
If you want to use olive oil, you can, but I love coconut oil, so let that melt up.
I do have to say, Cindy, because of the Italian in me, I do prefer olive oil, but...
I do, too, but you know, I love using olive oil for dressings, things like that, so I like to save it for that. So now I have cut up. We want to add in our flavors, so we have carrots, we have celery and onions that I already chopped up for you, but of course we need some garlic.
Garlic!
We can't have any Italian cooking without garlic.
Here's a disclaimer. I don't have my glasses on, so don't let me chop my fingers off.
Do not chop your fingers off. So, and be careful. That's a very sharp knife that I gave you. So, I'm just going to cook these up for a few minutes because we want them to get...
How much? This whole clove?
Oh, yeah. And you can add 2-3 cloves, whatever you want.
Yeah.
And I'm going to add in a little bit of salt and pepper.
Okay.
That seasoning here, that's beautiful, Jerry. So you want to add that right into the pot here. That's just lovely.
Stop. I don't want to see red here.
No, we do not want red. Okay.
All right, here we go.
So we'll add in the garlic.
All right.
So let that cook for a few minutes. Now we're going to add in some ground turkey. Okay, this is about a pound here. So we're going to add that in there and just cook it up. Now, if you want to use chicken sausage or...
You can kind of substitute the meat, but make sure it's lean.
You want lean meat,
absolutely.
So you can, like I said, you can use sausage, turkey, chicken, whatever is available at your market.
And then you saute this till it's nice and brown.
Absolutely. And then what we're going to do is add in a 28-ounce can of crushed tomatoes.
So the big honking
can. The big
can.
Now, we do want this a thick sauce, so a ragu really is a nice thick sauce. We want to let it simmer for a long time and just let it cook, and it will be amazing. Then once
it smells so good already. I wish you were all here right now.
Absolutely. So now we're going to add in our tomato paste, and that's going to help thicken up the sauce for us.
Okay.
Now, here, Jerry, is my Italian mix.
Okay, this is your signature mix of Italian spices.
This is my signature mix. So it has rosemary, thyme, oregano, basil, garlic powder, onion powder. It has everything in there.
Okay.
And what I like to do is I won't add it all because as we're cooking it, we want to taste.
Yes.
Don't we always taste our food as we're cooking it?
Okay.
So what we're going to do is let that simmer for a good 30 minutes.
Okay.
We're move this.
So do I add a little salt and pepper here?
I already did.
Oh, you already did.
I did. So we're going to add this one that's been cooking for about 30 minutes.
And by the way, don't be scared. We mentioned a lot of recipes. Look at that! Oh, my God. We're going to put all of this up on our website, daytimeonline.tv. So fear not. You're going to get the recipe.
Doesn't it smell
It smells
so nice.
Amazing.
So now we can bring over the spaghetti squash. Now, the way I made this, and I have some that are uncooked right here, is I took the spaghetti squash, cut it in half, laid it on the baking sheet, and just cooked it 375 for about 50 minutes.
Okay.
Very good. And this is what it looks like.
Okay.
So you grab your fork here.
Yeah. And you have to kind of, the only tricky part is taking the seeds
taking
out,
Seeds. But look how easy that is.
That is. Yeah.
Look how easy.
Not bad at all.
And then you get the rest of the strands here.
Okay.
Now what I'm doing is I'm putting it all into the pot.
And this is the substitute for your...
pasta. And it's going to be so good. So I have some here that I already did as well.
Okay, great.
Toss together.
Add it together.
And what's great about this dish, one pot. Look at, I have everything in one pot. And because I'm using this beautiful pan, I can bring this right to the table.
Right to the table.
Serve it family style.
You don't have to put this in the oven, do you?
Or no,
do you?
This is done.
That's done.
We
Look
can
at
serve
that.
It.
Let me taste that.
Oh, absolutely. Here. Here is a fork here.
All right.
Dig
oh,
in.
My God. Cindy Barbieri, can I just tell you something? Would you? I know you're in Florida now. You moved from the Northeast. And can you please come back?
Of course.
Will
I would love
that?
To come back and cook more for you.
Absolutely.
Tell me how that tastes.
Mm. Mangia, figlio mio. That is so good. Grazie tante. The book again is Paleo Italian Cooking, Cindy Barbieri. Grazie.
Thanks for having me.
We'll be right back.